Hi, this video is called Area of a Regular Polygon Formula. So by the time this video is done, you will have developed a formula for area of a regular polygon and done your first example using the formula. This first slide is dedicated to helping you see where the formula comes from. Instead of just giving it to you and asking you to trust me, you'll actually be able to see its development. We are going to use this regular pentagon. So by regular, we know all five sides are the same. We're going to use it to help us find our formula for area of a regular polygon. So even though I'm using a pentagon in my example, this formula will hold up for any regular polygon. So any sort of a shape that has all congruent sides and all congruent angles. All right, where to begin? I have my pentagon. I'm going to look at the shape underneath it. I've got a parallelogram up on the slide. You all have learned that area of a parallelogram is base times height, where the base and the height are perpendicular to each other. They meet at 90 degree angles. We're going to use that now to help us with our formula. So let's think about this. If I look at my pentagon for a minute, I've got one triangle sitting inside of it. I got that triangle by drawing in radii. Let's go ahead and draw in all five radii that a pentagon will have. And you can see that a pentagon that has five sides has been fairly easily broken into five congruent triangles. So why don't you go ahead and draw in the radii and then just kind of lightly shade in your five triangles. What I'm going to do is kind of pretend like I cut this pentagon into five triangles and see if I can fit it into the parallelogram below. So here we go. This is what's going to happen. I'm going to make my first triangle, move my first triangle down right here. I have four more to go. My second triangle, I'm going to put it right next to it. My third, my fourth, and my fifth. So what I've done is I've taken the five triangles that were in my pentagon and rearranged them so they're sitting nicely in that parallelogram. I did that because I know the formula for area of a parallelogram is base times height, so I'm going to use that to help me. Okay, so let's look at this. In my parallelogram, how much of the parallelogram was filled up? I have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 triangles that were filled up and 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 that were not. So if I know that the parallelogram is base times height, I think my pentagon will be base times height, but only half of that. So 1/2 base times height, or you could say base times height divide by 2. Mathematically, it's more proper to follow the formula 1/2 base times height, but base times height divide by 2 is the same thing because multiplying by 1/2 and dividing by 2 are the same. So you can see that we find the area of our pentagon by finding the area of a parallelogram and either multiplying by 1/2 or divide by 2. But now here's the thing. I don't want to have to do that every time where I take my shape and see how it fits into a parallelogram. So let's change our formula, and instead of using it in terms of the parallelogram using the base and height, could I rewrite it a little bit so it's in terms of my pentagon? So let's think about this. So what I'm trying to do is instead of using B and H, I want to use letters that come from my pentagon picture to help me. So looking at this, instead of calling the height H, what could I call it? Well, remember, if this is the base of my parallelogram, the height will be a distance that meets it at a 90 degree angle that's perpendicular. So this could be considered the height. This could be considered the height. This could be considered the height. This could be considered the height, and so could this. So instead of calling it H, let's call it A for that apothem or apothem. Okay? Now, what could I rename the base? Well, the base of my parallelogram was this entire bottom side, which looks like was the bases of all five of my triangles. So if I go back up in the picture, the bases of all five of my triangles are the distance around. What else could you call that? Well, the bases of the parallelogram, being the bottom five bases of my triangle, is actually the perimeter of my of my pentagon. So instead of calling it the base of the parallelogram, let's call it the perimeter of my pentagon. So my formula, my official formula for area of a regular polygon is 1/2 perimeter times apothem, where it's the perimeter of the pentagon and the apothem or the apothem of my shape. So we could say 1/2 P times A, or P times A divide by 2. Remember, both formulas are fine, but the 1/2 P times A is more mathematically proper. I personally don't care which one you use. Ask your teacher if they have an opinion. This is Mrs. Milton. So if you don't have Mrs. Milton, ask your teacher if they care which formula you use. All right, this video isn't quite done yet. Now that we have our formula made, let's just quickly go through one example so we can use the formula. When this video is done, you will be done with the front side of your note sheet. We are now in the block that says number 2, find the perimeter of the regular polygon. Well, this is just giving us a little bit of practice. If it's a regular polygon, that means all 5 of these sides are the same. Since one of them is marked with a 6, they all will be the 6. So what's the perimeter? You could say 6 plus 6 plus 6 plus 6 plus 6, or you can say 6 times 5. You're going to get a perimeter of 30 units. All right, let's go to the next slide. Again, we're just practicing little pieces, and we're going to put it all together really soon. Number 3 on the front side says find the central angle, or CA, in the regular polygon. Well, remember, the central angle goes from the center of your pentagon, out to the vertex. So since a pentagon has 5 sides, we'll have 5 radii. So that will make 5 central angles that are all the same. Well, like we mentioned before, all those central angles should add up to 360. And if they're all the same, we're going to divide by 5, and that gives us 72 degrees. So I know all 5 of these central angles are 72 degrees. Okay, again, just one piece to the puzzle. We're practicing all the different parts. We'll put it together soon. The next one, number 4, it says find the length of the apothem or apothem in the regular pentagon. Well, I'm going to just catch the picture up a little bit. All of these central angles were 72 degrees. And remember how all of these sides were 6. We talked about what the apothem or the apothem does to the side of your pentagon. When this apothem dropped down, it split that into 2, so we really had 3 and 3 here. So now I've got to kind of think about what could I do to find that apothem. Well, remember, in my pentagon, I've got 5 triangles going, and that apothem in that bottom triangle, it cut my triangle in half into 2 separate triangles, and it made a 90 degree angle. So sure enough, we have got a right triangle. So I'm taking this guy right here and making him bigger. We have a right triangle where this bottom side length was 3. Here's the apothem that I'm trying to find. And what happened to this central angle that was 72? Well, when you drop an apothem down and it cut the segment, it bisected the segment into 3 and 3, it also bisected the angle. So the 72 got cut in half to create 36. So we also have 2 angles that are both 36 degrees. So up here, I've got a 36, I've got a 90, and then I would also have, this would end up being a 54, because 36 plus 90 plus 54 is what adds up to 180. So now, hopefully, where everything's been pretty new, this is starting to look familiar, that we actually have SOHCAHTOA. It's not a 30-60-90, it's not a 45-45-90. So I'm going to use SOHCAHTOA to figure out what this apothem length is. So let's try to remember. You could go from the perspective of the 36 or the 54. I'm going to go from the 54. It makes the apothem my opposite and 3 my adjacent. Well, opposite over adjacent is a tangent. So I've got the tangent of 54 equals the opposite, which is a, for apothem, over the adjacent, which is 3. I'm going to put the tangent of 54 over 1. I'm going to cross multiply. A times 1 is A. The tangent of 54 times 3. Well, the A is already alone, so all I have left is to multiply. When I multiply those, I get it to round to 4.1. So my apothem is 4.1. All right, so now it's time to put it all together. You can see on this last slide on the front page, I've got a picture of my pentagon with a side length of 6. I just found that apothem length in my last slide to be 4.1. So let's find the area of the regular pentagon. So it's time to put it all together. My formula that I learned is 1/2 perimeter times apothem. So I need to replace the P with a number and the A with a number. I just got the apothem to be 4.1. And if you can remember, we've already gotten the perimeter to be 6 times 5, which was 30. So now it's just time to simplify. Since it's a multiplication, 1/2 times 30 times 4.1, can multiply it in whatever order I want. I'm just going to go left to right. 1/2 times 30, that's the same thing as 30 divided by 2 is 15. 15 times 4.1 gets me 61.5 units squared. So you have finally, in your longest video yet, just completed a problem to find the area of the regular pentagon. There's some things we're going to have to talk about with rounding. We'll deal with that in some later problems to really concentrate on that part. But for now, you've learned how to use 1/2 perimeter times apothem. You've just finished your first problem. Now it's time to do a lot more so you can get good at this.